Aaron Clark, we are beginning tonight with people in one Central Coast town trying to deal with a homeless problem. City leaders tell us the number of people seeking shelter at the Marley-Holtie Center, the only homeless shelter in town, has shot up from a dozen 3 years ago to almost 30 last year. That problem has some taking matters into their own hands. Pastors from Hollister's New Life Family Worship Center have been offering transitional housing to people who would otherwise be on the street. In the former Hazel Hawkins Hospital, now a commercial building, against city building and zoning codes. Action News reporter Stephanie Truong is live in our Salinas newsroom with more.
Aaron, city leaders say it's a case of Good Samaritans trying to get some homeless off the streets, even though what they did was illegal. The mayor says it does shed some light on the bigger issue of homelessness in Hollister. The issue of homelessness has plagued Hollister for years.
I used to drive down the street and say, why don't that guy get a job?
But now Mike Martin is that guy. Hefty medical bills to treat the arthritis he developed after years of roofing have forced him to spend his night sleeping in this bus stop corner in downtown Hollister.
You know, you go over one place, they kick you out. You go to another place, they kick you out. You know, and every human being has the right to sleep at night.
There's only one shelter, open during winter months, able to serve 26 people. So now some are finding their own ways to serve those in need of shelter. The former Hazel Hawkins Hospital building, now an office space, has in recent months become transitional housing for some people, offered by pastors from the New Life Family Worship Center. But living there is against the law.
I think the owner of the building had the best intentions, wanted to do a good thing, but we also have code violations. It's not set up for people to be living there.
Those people have until next month to vacate. In the meantime, Mayor Emerson says this incident highlights the need for a permanent homeless shelter as well as transitional housing.
If we could provide the services, if we had that year-round, maybe we could transition some of these people out of that condition.
City leaders say the problem extends to the entire Hollister community, a condition exacerbated by these rocky economic times.
You know, with the foreclosures, it is a glaring need, so we need not only affordable housing or rental housing, but we also need special needs housing and transitional housing.
Homelessness is not a crime. It's a situation, and looking at the way the banks and everything are going now, there might be a lot more of us out here pretty soon.
The mayor tells us that the homeless task force will be looking for transitional housing locations, a place to give people anywhere from 6 months to a year to pay minimal rent, save up, get a job, and eventually get back on their feet. And with the abundance of them, the mayor says they could be looking at foreclosed homes as potential sites. Aaron.
All right, Stephanie, thank you. The Hollister mayor does sit on the not-for-profit homeless task force, which he says has come up with a 5-year plan to bring services and build a permanent homeless shelter by 2013.